what they are right now. Mm-hmm. They're a fantastic team. You know, we had some questions. How are they going to do? A lot of people rated Origin maybe fourth or fifth place, you know, in the LCS, but they came out swinging. They're 5-0 right now, well on their way for 6-0, given, you know, how these matches or how these teams have been playing so far. But obviously, you can never tell before the game is played.
No, you cannot, and we can only speculate on those things. So starting off with the bans Rocket, they're going to go ahead and take away the Kalista. They're also going to ban Gragas, targeting out some favorites from Origin. And on their side, they remove the Ryze. That's been pretty much a staple ban across the board here in Europe, and the Rek'Sai as well, away from Jankos.
Yeah, Rek'Sai ban is just reactionary to the Gragas ban from Rocket. Amazing, saying, well, if I don't get a tier 1 jungler, you don't get a tier 1 jungler. See how Jankos adapts. Is he going to play the Lee Sin that we've seen so far? Is Evelyn going to get picked up early? And Rocket saying, yeah, we haven't really practiced Echo all that much, or we found a pick that we value higher.
Mm-hmm. Might be one of those junglers. We have seen those.
Might be LeBlanc too.
Jankos. Oh, and there's the ban.
Yeah.
It definitely might have been if that hadn't been the last ban for Origin. So off the board, Nuketuk won't get the chance. Rocket are going to prioritize their AD carry first and pick up a Sivir for Woolite.
Yeah, utility AD carry Sivir, early rotation. She can survive most laning phases, gets a CF deficit or some pressure, but if she can start pushing, she's generally fine in the game and provide utility for the team. And you can do a lot. You can put Sivir almost in every composition, and it works. But it'll be hard to use that rotational advantage against a team that already rotates so well, mm-hmm. or is just ready for these plays like Origin. Quite some options to their disposal.
Yes, indeed. They're definitely letting the time tick for a while, so they're going over the options that they do have.
I think we might see the Vayne come out again from Niels. Mm-hmm. Perhaps not on this rotation. Just get a generic support pick here. Then maybe a jungler already. We could see a Sejuani maybe, or an Evelyn, if Amazing is comfortable picking early. It looks like Soa's going to open with his pick. Get the top lane Fizz, Cinder, Hulk, Fizz here.
Yeah, Cinderfish worked out quite well for him yesterday. And Alistar, we never talk about him until he's locked in, it seems. But he's always come up pretty big, and Mythy definitely knows how to handle the Cal.
Yeah, and Alistar definitely allows your... While he doesn't put the most pressure on the likes of Sivir in laning phase, he allows your AD carry to get through laning phase, so we might see, still, as I said before, the Vayne come out, you know, dodge the Boomerang Blade, get into the mid-game, if we see more from what Rocket brings. Niels played a fantastic Vayne earlier. He can also just go for the Lucian. Doubt we'll see the Urgot here. Doesn't really seem to fit too well.
I've definitely got some options. So, Steve is going to head and take in his pick. That is going to be Rumble. And we also have the Nautilus locked in, so the bot lane is complete. Origin, now back to them.
A lot of damage on both top laners so far, so we might see a lot of jungle interaction. And for Origin, that's okay, because Origin is not a mid-centric team. They either play around their bot lane or either play around their top lane. Yesterday, they tried to get Soas ahead. Didn't really work. The Ryze got a little fed, but then Soas just started roaming around, picked up 3 kills, and suddenly he was back into the game. So Origin, while they have a game plan, if it fails, if it falters, they also have a plan B ready.
Mm-hmm. Well, and they have a plan C too, because you mentioned they don't really focus on the mid lane. That's because Pekka is just kind of doing his own thing. He said a couple weeks ago, yeah, you know, I was farming, then we won the game. When he gets involved, then you know it's serious, but it just hasn't had to happen yet. So Origin do go ahead and lock in the Evelyn. They're still waiting on their next pick. So with the jungle tier going down to the next one, we've got that locked in. And of course, Niels will opt to take Lucian as his AD carry.
If it wasn't Origin, I would maybe even call this draft a little, you know, I wouldn't say poor, but it looks a little weird to me. I just can't see quite puzzled quite together. Yes, I think Lucian is fine as a strong carry. I think Bruiser top Fizz is nice to dive in the back line. I guess Alistar can hold its own, but Evelyn is not really the main tank you want. You want another tank present to draw the aggro and allow this Evelyn to flank, but at the same time, Fizz kind of wants to flank as well. But if everybody wants to flank, then...
Who's going in front?
Who's
going
to take the tank? Yes, Alistar is... He can soak up damage, but he's not tanky, you know? He can pop Unbreakable Will for 6 or 7 seconds, mm-hmm. but he can't, you know, soak up much repetitive damage like the likes of Sejuani, for example, can, but see what they run it out with later on Pekka.
I suppose the Cinderhulk Fizz is tanky as well, but you're right. They just don't have a true tank. They don't have really enough of what they need, but maybe they're just very confident in the ability to outplay Rocket as they look to lock in their last choices. It is going to be Lee Sin after all for Jankos, and for Nuketuk, we've got Nazir.
Are we going to see the Vladimir response again? We've seen Froggen pick Vladimir into Azir. We saw the Azir-Vladimir matchup in the other way around in the Copenhagen Wolves game. I think where Soren still locked the Azir and just couldn't really get ahead of his opposing Vladimir. And we've seen Pekka play Vladimir too into Azir with success, and exactly here it comes out. And the reason he does that is because he's he's very hard to gank in the mid lane. We've seen many teams just swing their jungle around mid, peek their heads in, and then Peke would just pull out, play fine on his own, farm up to a Storm, and then eventually enter the fights if his team hasn't already won the game by then. But I like Rocket's draft way more than I like Origins. If I look at it and I couldn't see the team names on top of it, then I would definitely say Rocket won this draft. However, Origin,
they're still
a very
Origin.
Smart team, and they can make these champions work, but it'll be a lot more complex.
Yeah, that is always a question. Let's see if this one does end up pushing them to their limits a little bit more. But the coaches on your screen there, Leduc, and of course Yamato Cannon. What are they saying to their teams as they will have their final seconds here on stage before they have to exit and the game will begin? It really has been an interesting dynamic adding coaches this year to the LCS, and they'll be shaking hands walking off the stage.
Now, while usually we see Rocket leave Steven on the island and get behind early and then try to help him, I really feel they should be in time to defend him, because I think the top lane is definitely where this match is going to play out, because Peke dodges ganks easily, but Steve, he has died a lot, and so has if he gets going, he makes picks left and right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he has been able to do it time and time again. Let's see if he can do it again. What do you guys think? Why don't you go ahead and tweet us your predictions? That is, of course, at LOL Esports, hashtag ROCWin or hashtag OGWin. See who you think is going to take this game. Will be Rocket grabbing themselves another on the books, or will Origin match Fnatic's perfect start at 6-0? Only time will tell. And let's find out as we load up onto the Rift. So here we go onto Fountain. Focus on Peke right now. It hasn't really been the Peke show in this Origin squad, but he's definitely playing a very comfortable champion in Vlad.
At first I thought he was holding a bouquet, and then I realized that was mildly blind, and it's just bouncing blood. Hemoglobin. The camera does love Peke.
It
he is
really
a handsome
does.
Man.
It's very true.
Can't deny it.
We'll see the rest of the map in just a minute. But everyone's lining up pretty normal start right here. Take a look at some of Peke's stats so far. Even though he hasn't been the most valuable player on his team in terms of numbers, he's still done absolutely fantastic across the board when he what he needs to do. KDA, those are numbers that'd be the envy of many a mid laner. And he really hasn't had to get involved.
12.5 KDA is a lot, but it almost feels like it's the lowest on his team, because he's just not part of the action. Until 22 minutes in the game, roughly, usually he just barely joins, and he has like one kill out of the 11 that OG has by then. But enough history. Let's go back into the game here. Teams, both of them going for the deep wards, going for the lane swap wards. Let's figure out why. Who wants to swap? I guess Steve is better on low farm because Rumble still does a lot of damage. And Rocket definitely is a team that wants to group around objectives, right? So they want to get those dragon fights going early. They can still put Rumble behind. And they want to keep Soaz down, I guess. But if they lane swap, Soaz has a smite. So that speaks in favor for him. So
yeah, and Soaz versus Steve, I mean, this is a matchup where experience is going to be very, very key. Soaz has been absolutely tearing up every top laner he encounters. And even though the Rumble looks pretty good on paper overall, still, it's going to be a very tough challenge for him if he takes a straight 1v1. Don't think it's going to happen.
Now, with this lane swap playing out like it is, swapping the slightly weaker Sivir into the top lane, what freezing here? Freezing usually means that this enemy top tower is not going to go down too early. This gives Origin a lot of time, and I said before how Rocket's a lineup that actually plays well around dragon fights. It's very likely that Origin eventually will pick up the first dragon, and this buys them more time. Then they're not forced to play around the next few dragons. So it'll obviously take Rocket a while to get to that first dragon on their team, second and then third, the big one that you want to watch out for.
Mm-hmm.
So this actually plays into Origin reasonably well. So Soaz double jungle's fine with Smite. Yes, Fizz wants to get level advantage so he can later assassinate the AD carries, but it's not, you know, disaster if he can't.
Yeah, I'm wondering really who you got to focus in all of these. I suppose the primary target is probably going to be Nuke Duck, but still hard to catch in Azir. He's a little bit slippery.
And from Rocket's side, this might be a new adaptation. They say, okay, every time we play, we kill our top laner Steve. We don't want Steve to die anymore. We like him. So we're going to go on a buddy system.
Send him in
Steve
the jungle.
And yank us together forever.
It's a fantastic pairing right there. See how long it goes as Amazing and Soaz are doing the same thing. Start going towards the bottom. We might be seeing a 4v0 push by Origin.
Yeah, they definitely don't want to send anybody top to risk a dive, so they initiate the 4v0. Now Rocket will have to answer. Rendering that freeze almost useless. Let's see how many minions Rocket has here. So Wulight now decides to push in for the 4v0. He stacks like a wave and a half. There's on the bot lane, almost a double wave stack pushing in for Origin here. Overall, it won't matter that much.
Yeah, Origin's actually going to opt to just go ahead and start doing the dragons. Taking Soa is pretty low here, but all the same, greedy, but it's not going to be punished because they know exactly where Rocket are. They know what they're moving for, and they should be able to grab the tower and also the dragon. It might take a while.
Yeah, this tower is going down slow on the top lane. Yes, the dragon is slow to take, but Origin's safety. And I think Origin takes the better end of this trade here,
oh, yeah.
In my opinion. They take a tower and a dragon. They don't really get too far behind. They speed up the process. What a 4v0 usually does is it tells the enemy team, hey, we're taking this tower. You better do the same or we'll swap the lanes back up and eventually get our top laner back into a solo lane. It doesn't get denied too much. Mm-hmm. The important part here is see how these waves behave. If they get bounced back, if you don't know what a bounce means, you want the wave to push back to your side after you take a tower. Deny the enemy farm, allow your top laner to pick it up a minute ahead in time.
Exactly. So, looks like we're about equal on the towers. They're both going to fall just about the same time, but Origin also picks up the dragon.
Double bounce.
Worth noting, though, there's that double bounce. Yesterday, they did the same thing against Unicorns. They forced the 4VO when it was lane freeze was a little bit more preferred by their opponents, and they got off to a flying start. They were massacring them. But, of course, they've done this to everybody, too. So we'll see what Rocket can do to try and stop that tide from a flowing, but
Where's
so
the,
as.
The second the lane stops over, the enemy jungle is already there to gank him. It almost becomes predictable at this
point. No more buddy system for Steve.
He was safe, though. After this first death yesterday, he managed to survive, and the lead didn't get any bigger. But yeah.
Well, he's staying safe for now, as you see Amazing has backed off. But Soaz and Niels are not keen to give him a whole lot of this wave that's going to come a crashing into his tower. And he knows it, so he's going to have to back off.
I like this adaptation. Because the dragon is down, Origin don't need their teleport. They have about a minute window of time, or minute 30, to use that teleport to their advantage. Some different way. So what they do is they send Soaz top and they tell Rocket, hey, our top lane is actually top. That means our bot lane is likely to go back bottom. But then suddenly Niels shows up and they catch Rocket off guard. Now they have two members in the bot lane pushing and the jungler. So Soaz, he wants to initially get back to this tower. Rocket denies that though right now. But that was initially the move that Origin wanted to make. And this is a good counter by Rocket sending three people there. So Soaz can't pick up that farm. And the tower falls on that side.
Yeah,
now Steve gets a little shafted because of this. He gets zoned off his tower. He gets put behind a bit. Yeah. And in the Soaz-Steve matchup, Soaz gets a little bit ahead.
Yeah, so Steve is going to have a little bit of a hard time getting to his item spikes and getting into a powerful position. But at the very least, he's not being camped. He's not being dove. So maybe he'll find this side of the coin a little bit more preferred. And
when you're doing camps, you call it a camp.
It's true.
It's a multiple for Steve.
Very good wisdom there. Tower's going to go down. Rocket are taking their time to, once again, deny this farm from Soaz. Yeah. But they do have it a little bit ahead. It's not going to matter much because Origin are right on their heels. So a lot of very early towers, you know, we've pretty much gone all the way back to the 4VO. Not just a single one, but one, then the other. And then the mid lane continues to just be a farm fest with a little bit of poke on the side.
So you're saying both things on each side, a mirrored game. However, in the midst of all of that, Origin managed to do it more efficiently because they have a Dragon and a 13 CS lead on Xpekka right now. He's playing Vladimir Azir matchup. He got poked out a little bit in the first few levels, but that's okay. If the map is being played not around the mid lane, if the mid lane is an island, then Vladimir doesn't mind getting poked because eventually he'll sustain up. We've seen no ganks come in. Pekka's playing safe. He doesn't care if he's on half HP or full HP. As long as he doesn't give Nuketuk the ability to all in him and get that one kill lead. He's ahead a couple CS. Origin is doing what they do best, but they're not getting as many kills as they usually have.
No, and that's a really good point. Normally by this time, it's already devolved into a bloodbath, and Origin have thrived on picking fights, on getting catches, see if they're able to do it again. But for now, they're playing a much slower game, and Rocket, this is their signature calling card. Now, Mithy's going to get caught by Jankos and Vander, but there's not that much damage there, and Amazing is there to respond.
Yeah, vision control around Dragon is paramount right now. Origin wants to set up a couple of wards, so when Rocket goes for that dragon control, okay, let's see where Rocket is going. So Origin doesn't get caught off guard. At the same time, Rocket, they will want to have the same dragon control so they can use their composition to their advantage. Posture around the dragon, use on the hunt to their advantage, and try and punish Origin when they try to flank. Because when you flank, you fan out, and then your weak side can get engaged on, and especially with the likes of Sivir, it opens up to very quick engages.
Yeah, they have to be very, very careful. Origin, know those timing windows. Utter surety. Rocket, play the defensive game yet again. This is something that talked about quite a lot last split. They've definitely been trying to play it again this split. So far, they've only been able to find one win in the five games they've played. It'll be a tall order to find another one against Origin here, but they are certainly trying.
Now, we've been talking about Dragon, we've talked about Mirror Game, but we haven't really looked at the CS in the top lane too much, and it tells a grim tale. Steve just got his 10th CS 9 minutes into the game. He hasn't died, but he may as well have, because he lost a lot of gold compared to Soa. Soa's at 42 CS. Yes, Steve might pick up some farm, but if my math is correct, there is not 30 creeps in that wave.
Yeah, that is definitely correct math there. So Steve in some trouble. We'll have some breathing room now as the pause comes in. We'll have to find out what is that is about as we focus on Origin. So it's taking stock of where we are. We're not quite at 9 minutes, just under that. And it has been a very even game, as any game with Origin can be right now. However, as you mentioned, they're doing things a little bit more efficiently. They're getting themselves little leads. It's almost like what we saw Fnatic doing, just tiny little things, tiny little things. However, they're just not vastly ahead in the early game.
Yeah, they just play the same game their opponents do, but better so far. Let's take stock of some of the items we've seen here right now. Because the game, in a lane swap rather, you know, you don't get these long farming lanes where AD carries pick up 55 CS and get that BF sword. The game slows down, so you base, and first base you get a pickaxe, and you're forced to base again, you get that average blade. So Wu-Lite, he's stacking up some extra gold here. Niels, he picked up the longsword. He wants to maybe evolve that a little more in a different path. Tier 2 boots picked up already for him, so he's more mobile. They can move him around easier. He can move around quick too, but he'll have to use his ulti for that.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think Soas must be sitting on a lot of gold here. Let me just quickly check on my screen. Yeah, he's about 1.6k gold ready to spend. Mm-hmm. And he's already 700 gold ahead of Steve.
Yeah, he hadn't even picked up his Skirmisher Saber just yet, so that'll make him a completely different fish as the game goes on. And it's going to be really hard for Steve to get relevant in this game.
I mean,
yeah, it doesn't matter if you avoid death. He's just he's still a Rumble. He's going to peak in a mid-game, but he's, you know, he could miss that window. I mean, that's a real danger there for him.
The first, ironically, yeah, the first Equalizer that he casts will make or break this game almost, I feel. I feel we might see some exploding action around the second Dragon. That will come up because Rocket will have to take that one, because otherwise they have this composition that plays so well around dragons in the early mid game, and if they don't get this one, they will have given up two dragons already to Origin by maybe the 12-13 minute mark, and then the game can snowball out of their control pretty rapidly.
And we all know what Origin can do when they have been able to secure all those buffs, everything else on the map.
Now, the shining light so far for Rocket has been Jankos in his split. Very low amount of deaths. Very high amount of kill participation, so he's been doing fantastic, even in a struggling Rocket. You know, the stats that we saw on the analyst desk yesterday for him, it didn't look like he was in a team that was in a losing position, in a 1-3 team coming into this week. Fantastic play, and he has this early game jungler, but due to the lane swap that Rocket initiated, he can't use that to his advantage. You know, he used to be the first bot king.
Now he's not even really nobility anymore. That's the problem. He's had a good score. But Rocket altogether, they've not really been able to execute their plans outside of just let's be a little defensive, let's not allow the enemy to get a huge jump on us. And eventually it just seems like they're getting pushed in over and over again. And regardless of how long this game does end up going, Origin have shown that they can really thrive in either a quick-paced game or a very slow, drawn-out one like we saw against SK Gaming. And speaking of Origin, just to let you guys know what's going on, Amazing was feeling a little bit ill, so he stepped away for just a moment and, you know, we give him some time to feel a little bit better, recover. But looking across the board, speaking of the junglers, we already talked a little bit about Jankos, about Amazing. How really has this Evelynn fit in so far, would you say, in this game?
I mean, any pick could have done the same right now, obviously, because we've been in a lane swap. Jungler has become more of a supported role. They duo jungle. Evelynn clears pretty quickly, but falls pretty low. So in a double jungle scenario, she's actually pretty nice because you can juggle the aggro a little bit with the fizz there on Soas. Soas also brings an extra smite into the equation. So the double jungler, I feel, goes pretty quick on Origin side. Rumble, Flamesmitter works a little bit. But Lee Sin, you lose the gank potential already against a mid lane that's so hard to gank like Xpeke. Yes, you can find an opening with the Lee Sin, but then in a lane swap, in these scenarios that we keep finding ourselves in, like the 4-0 swap back over, you know, try and get another tower, and you see tower mirrored on each side of the map drop down, then it becomes very hard for Lee Sin to do anything. And I feel if Rocket can't find that opening, then they give enough time for Origin to scale. Because if you look at the drafts, I still think overall, if I wouldn't look at teammates, I wouldn't look that this was Origin on one side and Rocket on the other side, that I really like their draft a lot more.
Yeah. Nonetheless, Origin have still had slightly better game in the early stages, but it has been fairly even. You know, you took a look at that gold score. That doesn't really differentiate much. It's 2 towers to 2 because of the very early 4VO pushes. And the timing is really, like, so small. And the big difference right now is that one dragon.
Yeah, definitely that one dragon. I mean, we've touched upon it before, so I need to go back to it. But the one thing I feel that could be Rocket's saving grace is the fact that Vander, you see it already, you know, first priority sidestone. Vander is a support that wards a lot. And he keeps the people safe. And if you can somehow spot out what Origin is doing and then try to be smart enough to think ahead and think in their heads, you know, what would Origin do? Something a lot of teams should think about.
Yeah, split, I think that's definitely
then,
fair.
Then you can place the right wards and try and slow them down and maybe, you know, find an opening eventually with combining the Equalizer with On the Hunt and having the Nautilus ulti come in there. The crowd is clapping, so I think this is the return of Amazing. Really? Hope so.
It looks like we'll be getting ready to get back into the game pretty shortly, as there he is on your screen. So, this game's about to get back underway. We've had a bit of a pause. The teams can take stock of what's been going on. What does Rocket really need to do to get themselves in an advantageous position? Because it's still very early and it's still very even.
Find an opening on the second dragon that's going to spawn. It's 55 seconds from now. We can see that on our screens. Sadly, you can't. You have our ugly mugs on it. Oh, well, mine. Not Pyro, of course.
Very oh, that's man. Okay, dude.
But yeah, hopefully we get back soon into game. One thing, though, Amazing, even though he got back onto the desk, he might still be, you know, a little thrown off, you know. You never know how a player feels when he's sick, and I just hope it doesn't mess with him too much, because so far he has had a fantastic split. That's definitely the supportive jungler that Origin needs. He ties it all together.
Yeah, he really has been absolutely fantastic since his return to Europe here, and Origin's blazing through the Challenger Series last spring. Let's see what they continue to do. Origin now staggering their backs just a little bit. Peke's already gone back to buy, and so is Soaz. Origin is having the vision advantage on this dragon, still 20 seconds away.
Now, in a game as slow as this, you might not look for too much action, so something you should, as a spectator, always watch out for is these side waves and the minion waves and generally how they behave. We saw earlier Soaz pushing top lane. It takes Steve time to push that out. He still not only hasn't met the midpoint just yet, so spot him enough time to see at least where Steve was. Soaz had the option to maybe rush the dragon if he wanted to. He decides to go top, push that wave back in, and Niels is dealing with the bot lane, so this is why Origin's not going for dragon, because Rocket pushed into waves and they want to make a pick.
They do, and they find Mythy. Let's see if they can take down the cow. They do. That's first blood right off the bat. Now Amazing on the retreat path as Yankos dodges away. There's the fire burning him down, and Yankos will manage to pick up a kill onto dragon for Rocket.
Fantastic play by Rocket, exactly what he needed. I said look at the side waves. Top wave was pushing, bot wave was pushing. Rocket group popped on the hunt, made a play on that second dragon, secured a dragon and 2 kills, and they're now 1,000 gold ahead.
Yeah, I said right before the pause ended, Kreppo, what they needed to do was create an opening for dragon, and boy did they. 2 kills, and then to equalize that, absolutely fantastic. They have themselves a gold lead now. Rocket are looking great.
Now, Origin, it almost felt like they were sleeping a little bit. They had Niels defend the bot lane, they had Soaz defend the top lane, so only Miffy and Amazing to clear his wards, and if you don't see your enemies at that point, you should be careful. Steve, he picked up some farm. He's now on 27 CS, still down 30 to Soaz. But this gives so much, it gives momentum to Rocket, and exactly what they needed.
Yeah, they've had great early games against some teams, even the ones they've lost, a lot of the teams they've lost against, and they just haven't really capitalized on it as much. I'm curious to see as the game goes on what they do next, how they change their mindset, how they get a little bit more proactive, and if Origin allows them to do that, because it's still only a minor setback for them.
Rocket has to use their side waves to get vision of some of the Origin members. Make sure they ward their flanks when it got caught off by the Cinderhulk, Fizz, or the Evelynn diving in the backline, and then group up with On the Hunt and use those defensive peel tools of Emperor's Divide and the Lee Sin kick in case they get caught, and just use the offensive CC like the Equalizer, like the Nautilus Ultimate, to catch somebody out, try and punish him without taking too much damage. That's what they want to do. They want to play around On the Hunt, so every cooldown for them trying to orchestrate something. But Origin's a smart team. They failed to it once right now. It's gonna be harder next time around for Rocket.
Fool them once. May not be quite as hard as twice. Nuke Duck looking to clear the waves in the middle, turns his attention onto Peke. Some Sand Soldier damage there. Think twice about shoving too far in, but Origin are actually fairly deep in this jungle all around. Amazing places himself a deep ward.
Counter deep wards by Rocket. That's exactly what you wanna do. Push up a lane, translate that lane push into deep vision. Top lane's pushing, allows Rocket's support and jungler to move in and get deep vision. Peke push in mid, allowed Mythi and Amazing to walk in and drop some deep vision. Steve had to back out of the bot lane because he's facing the assassin fishy Soas. Now what? He's knocking on the top tower.
He's got a little bit of a wave there. Vander is providing some cover, and so is Yankos. So as Mythi and Niels look to close the net, they realize it won't be as easy as that.
Now what?
Be able to back away.
One thing that Origin is lacking here is wave clear.
It's true.
Fizz not much wave clear. Hate spikes. Takes you a while to get through that creep wave. Peke, yeah, but it's very close range, so he can get punished for it by the Azir, as we see right here. And then Niels, he can use a culling, but that's about it. So and it's some of the pitfalls that Element sometimes fell into. It's not enough wave clear, but we might see another On the Hunt forcing something here, though.
We might, as the ward goes down. Amazing is going to be the one to get packed in, and Woolite will take him down. Teleport in for Soaz, but the fight is already on. Yankos is burning down the blood. He'll be going down with the Hemo Plague. Double kill over to Vladimir as he's able to take down Vander. Soaz, however, is melting. Equalizer's down. Mythi is zoned out of this one, and Peke isolated from him. But in comes the calling around the side from Niels. Woolite heals, but it's not enough. Steve is going to burn a flash, but Niels is on him. Another summoner heal popped just for the speed up, and Steve is trying to get away. The headbutt has no damage. Steve walks it out.
Steve getting the eject button from Mythi. If this was old Alistar, we would have seen headbutt slap. Sadly, no longer possible, which is why Alistar is no longer a top lane pick and just a support pick here. But Rocket, they try to find an opening. They wanted to use that lack of wave clear from Origin to their advantage. They pushed in Origin, hit in their jungle, popped on the hunt, found Amazing, but then Peke came in with so much damage, and we've talked about this before. Watch Peke, watch what he does in this fight. Amazing instantly drops, so this is 45, but Peke, and as we said, plan C. If something goes wrong, resort to plan B. If it goes really wrong, Haywire, and we actually start losing, well then we activate our trap card, and that is Peke in this fight. Untouched, unfocused. Buys enough time for Niels to come in here. Comes in with the culling, flashes in aggressively. Peke eventually goes down, but and Niels barely in range.
Just...
And yeah, the bane of your existence. Mythi was probably very close to combo. Alistar at this level usually puts a couple of points in Pulverize. Let's see, yeah, 3 points in Pulverize and one in Headbutt. Once he gets to the fourth rank of Pulverize, that's when a Headbutt Pulverize combo is on the exact same cooldown. But Peke?
Oh, he could be down. Yes, he is. Yankos will send a foot through his face as Mythi and Amazing were too slow to respond. Rocket are playing aggressive, trying to throw Origin off.
I really like Rocket finally stepping up. Slow early game, slow lane swap, but they realize that they have to use that On the Hunt to their advantage. They have to keep grouping. Punish the lack of wave clear. Don't let Origin scale. Don't let them set up flanks, and definitely doing so.
Mm-hmm.
Good game by Rocket.
Very good. Now, Dragon's up in another minute, too. The teams are at 1-1 here. We saw what Rocket was able to do last time. The question is, will Origin be a little bit more prepared? Right now, there's not a lot of Origin vision in that bottom side jungle. They've been focusing more on the top side, closer to the river, where we saw all that crazy action.
Now
what's this going to do?
Now let's see how good Rocket is at managing these waves. They have time before this top wave becomes a threat. Will I just clear the big wave on the bottom? Is he going to fast push that, slow push that, stack that wave? I wonder what they're going to do with it. What is Rocket's plan here? Are they going to execute it well?
Yeah, that's got to be the question right now, because Rocket, you know, this is a team that we've been saying, even in their losses, they've looked improved, but how much is always the question. If they can keep taking it to Origin here, and right now they have themselves a nice little advantage, nowhere near comfortable, but still.
Woolite went for the fast clear on a wave that was being approached by a cannon. So mean that eventually the wave will bounce back. I would have liked him to see kill only the range creeps, leave the melees alive, slow push that bot wave, and then stack up a massive threat for Origin that they will have to deal with. This could have opened up the dragon. And instead, Origin is not contesting it at all.
No, they're not in position to do it. So dragon number two for Rocket is the third one on the game. Origin instead opt to go up the top side and clear away some vision as well as grab themselves a blue buff. But that's a small consolation prize. Meanwhile, Rocket are starting to knock on the bottom second tier. Rocket are out rotating right now.
Yeah, they see that Origin is ready to go for that top tower, potentially die, but they have the equalizer to deal at least with one wave. So one ticket for wave clear on Steve here. Can't even force to use it, and then Peke, the only really wave clear from Origin, is forced to deal with that bot wave, but can he do it on his own? The answer seems yes.
Yeah, for rotation now, to mid. Chicken. Let's move back in, boys. Let's see what they can do. It looks like they might be on a collision course for the mid. Yankos lying in wait as Nuke Duck brings up the lane, pinged out, so Origin knows this is happening. Looks like we won't see any aggression just yet.
Yeah, a lot of tension in the air right here.
Whoop.
You don't want to be the team that gets caught in rotation here. You don't want to be lost in rotation here either. Meanwhile, Peck is becoming a bit of a threat. 145 CS, 2 kills, split pushing on the bottom. Who's going to deal with Peck later?
Somebody will certainly have to. Nukeduck's definitely done quite well versus him, but it really hasn't been about these laning phases. That ended pretty quickly. We saw the double 4-0 happening, and the game seemed to be going one direction, but after the pause, everything went haywire, and we have seen Rocket come out ahead, but Origin are still pushing back wherever they can. Rocket, however, what I really love about what they're doing right now is they're doing it with vision. They're not going in blind. They're not letting Origin get the jump on them.
Yeah, systematic approach from Rocket here, and they've stopped the bleeding. Steve now tightens that gap to 30 CS. However, Uso was going to pick up a lot of creeps there. They got a little wider yet again, but I talked about it in Champ Select, and the first dragon was crucial for Origin because we see it right now. One dragon to two. This could have very well been zero dragons to three for Rocket, and then you start having a timer on that game, because then you're only 12 minutes away from having that, you know, ultimate five dragons coming out, snowballing their composition. We're in the mid game right now. This is where Rocket wants to strike. They want to use Rumble to their advantage. They want to use On the Hunt to their advantage. Lee Sin will eventually fall off to an extent.
They
need to make something happen. But Origins, they're hanging on.
See if they can hang on to this tower. It's amazing. Just outside the range of the Boomerang Blade, Woolite will
Yankos is
step
flanking.
In, step out. Yankos is looking to come around, but so is Peke. Rocket will get cold feet here.
A little bit respect out of Rocket. I mean, they're facing almost three melee range clear champions. Lucian, of course, is ranged, but he doesn't have the most wave clear, and they don't get too much damage on the tower. They allow Peke to roam from bot to mid and help out his teammates right here, and they want to keep that mid tower alive. If that one falls, then the map opens up. Then you can get, again, deep vision, and then we might see a repeat of what Fnatic did earlier. Push in all the lanes. Get rid of the vision. Make it dark and force the fish check.
For now, though, Soaz is hoping that Steve will face check into him. Instead, he throws down the ward and keeps on walking. Soaz, after clearing the Grump.
Might see some action here.
Looks to jump on him. He's got that farm advantage. Playful and Trickster right on in, but the fish is flashed.
Flying fish there. Poor Soaz not connecting. Steve burns his flash, so he won't have that for the next fight.
Ult for Summoner. Usually not that bad of a trade.
I mean, it's usually a trade where both parties are happy. Pekka's going in, though.
Flashes and ults. Woolite. A lot of damage on him. Pekka was able to suck some blood out.
He spell shielded the ulti, I believe, so that's what kept him alive.
Yeah, that definitely helped. And now Vander here. Oh, speaking of Vander, he's going to go ahead and flash on Amazing. We'll get knocked up. They're looking to take
good
this
flash.
One. He flashes away from the dredge line. That, of course, means the Yankos can't get involved.
If you wait for that dredge line to hit and then flash, there's still a very large risk that you get caught. But yeah, so as he forced Steve back, and he has some pressure right now. No wards. He's a very nimble top laner, and he's slowly starting to push his advantage. He's finally picking up the Cinder Hulk, getting some magic resistance, so Steve has a very hard time dealing with him. And time is on Origin's side when it comes to scaling.
Mm-hmm.
Peke later in these fights, he will do enormous amounts of damage. He uses Flash, doesn't have... Yes, I think he actually had the Distortion Boost already. And that's what he wants to do. This tells a tale for Xpeke, right? He wants to get as many Flashes and Ghosts in, dive in, do some damage, pull out, go back into the fight later. Zhonyas, pull again, you know, become this very hard to deal with carry. Meanwhile, you have Soaz, playful Trickster, you know, left, right, Evelyn coming from unpredictable action, or angle rather, and then Miffy popping a breakable will. So very complex team fights, a lot of target switching required.
And this is the most active we've seen Peke really be since rejoining the LCS here. We'll see if he's able to stop this wave from happening, but I don't know if he'll be able to do that one. In comes Soaz, the fish is on, Nukeduck. Who is going to get jumped on, but Soaz might have gone a little too far forward. Mithy,
Pulverize,
that's what they needed. Will Origin be able to get the pickoff? Niels going low. The equalizer equalizes Niels. Peke is pulling away, but Rocket have surrounded him. And that's another kill. Yankos picks up one.
Origin tried to even out the gold lead, but instead they get equalized by Steve. And this is the first time at 20 minutes that Origin finds themselves behind in gold. Usually they're 3,000, 4,000 gold ahead. Suddenly they're struggling. They give up another two kills, and the next dragon, Pyra, 30 seconds away.
Yeah, fortunately they'll be able to respond by then, but still, this is definitely the toughest opponents have played to them. Let's take a look at that again. It looks so good for Origin to start, but then...
Yeah, engage on Nukeduck. I've said this before, they have to flank, because if you all come from the same angle, even a three-man combo can't save you, because you always have that Azir kiting backwards. You have the Equalizer cutting off your entire path. If you move from one direction, from point A to B. It's very easy for Steve to know where he has to put his equalizer, but if you come from point A to B, from C to B, from D to B, from all angles, then Rocket doesn't know what to do. You have to confuse them.
Yeah, and Mythy, he did what he needed to do there. He just didn't have enough in the tank. I really thought it was going to go their way when he set that up with a combo. But now...
So did Niels, because he dashed in aggressively, but it just wasn't quite enough, because normally when Origin does this, they have a 3,000 gold lead. And then yes, if you see that three-man combo, you can dash in, you can win that fight, but they have to play these fights differently. They have to wait a little more. They can't just go by the front door because they have to fight.
Yeah, this is almost the problem of winning too many games. It sounds a really weird phrase, but...
I never had that problem.
There you go. So clearly you're not in a position like this.
It's been a while since I had that problem.
Peke's got to be careful here. There's a big wave at his front door. Rocket, they just keep coming forward. And now Origin, they're pushed back further and further. The gold lead's widened to about 4,000 after that third dragon was taken by them. Yes, they've got Soaz splitting around the side, but he's not providing enough pressure.
Yeah, and this is something I usually fault Elements for, playing these low-pressure compositions that are very skirmish-heavy. And yes, if you get ahead, you can absolutely outplay your opponents. But if you're low on wave clear and somehow you find yourself behind, then the tempo is on your opponent's side. And you can never out-rotate, you can never out-match your opponent because you're playing a step from behind. Steve forcing Soaz's teleport?
Yeah, Origin find themselves in an unfamiliar situation. Rocket looking to pick up their second win this split and looking to be the first team to hand a defeat to Origin. Let's see if it can happen.
We'll get ahead of ourselves, Pyro.
It's still a lot of league to play, you're very right. But still, this is the best I feel Rocket have looked in this split so far, and this, I don't want to say the worst Origin have looked, but that's definitely the largest deficit they've had, and the only deficit they've had past 20, really.
Their only deficit, and just going to Rocket's side, they picked up their coach Yamato Cannon, and he was complimented occasionally for his drafts when he was coaching MYM. And he did a solid draft yet again. I really like what the composition Rocket ran. They kind of shot themselves in the foot a little bit by the lane swap because they had to get through the laning phase. I feel they didn't want that Rumble Sivir lane get Steve behind. So it was a necessary evil, but they picked up afterwards. They realized what they had to do, what they were strong at, and executed it beautifully.
Yeah, the one thing that really has eluded Rocket up until this point, up until this game, is making the most of whatever they need to do. So we've seen early games that just go awry in the mid. They just haven't been able to follow up execute. We've seen them just get completely beat down at all stages. And this time, this is the first game we've seen in a few weeks that they have really been able to take an advantage and to use it properly.
And definitely so. And I almost feel like this is the longest Steve has gone without dying in a game.
It's improving week after week.
Caught behind in CS a little bit early, but he's catching up. Actually, I lied. He's not catching up, but he's doing well.
Well, when you're versus Soaz, it's a little rough. Let's see what happens here as Mythy gets caught. In comes Jankos, goes for the insect. No one was really there to answer, except for now. Vanders, come on in. Woolite will pick off Mythy. Steve from around the side, burning as Niels goes down. A double kill over to Woolite to secure that one. It ends up being a 2-for-1 with Jankos giving his life and Xpeke nearly following.
And we often say Woolite should stop flashing in aggressively in fights, but when Rocket has a gold lead of this magnitude, then he can do it. It picks up another kill, and Origin playing these fights as if they're winning, but that's not enough.
They can't
take these fights like this, and Rocket keeps deciding the tempo, keeps deciding the pace, pick up another tower, another two kills. Mm-hmm. Beautiful opening, Jankos again with an insect. Yes, he pays with his life. Well worth, so.
Absolutely worth. They've continued to push forward. Let's see how this happened again. It did all start with Jankos and with Vander pulling in Mythy.
So I said this before, Alistar, he can't be your frontline because you'll have to pop Unbreakable Will without actually, you know, being in the fight. Amazing gets caught in the fray as well. Eventually, Mythy still drops in his Unbreakable Will duration and Steve comes in. Yes, he's behind 120 CS to 180, but look at the damage he did on Niels. And Woolite flashes in aggressively to pick up the second kill. He is now 4-1 in 5. Three items completed, big spite.
Yeah.
Spike Router, he went for the Eye Edge into Static Shift, and this speeds up your last Whisper if you're winning. Ness, you may think that PD is a little better Phantom Dancer, but it speeds up your last Whisper so quick. Shred even more armor.
Yeah, and you know, speaking of Woolite, we really haven't talked about him this much this game, but he's had a fantastic performance. He's been exactly where he needs to be. Yes, that aggressive flash has burned him in the past, but this time it's working out well for Rocket. He's still hanging further back from his front line. They're making very good use of this composition as the mid-game starts to draw to a close. Origin have scaling on their side, as you mentioned, but they might be a little too far behind at this point.
definitely falling pretty far behind, and they don't have the composition. Some compositions are okay with being a little bit behind because they have catch-up tools. Usually, in high amounts of wave clear, or one very strong champion that can split push, Origin has neither. So as yes, he's not too far behind, he hasn't died too much, he has a decent amount of farm, but he can't draw that much aggro that allows Origin to survive on the other side of the map because, again, they just don't have the wave clear for it. They're forcing these all-in type of fights, and if they can't flank, it's easy for Rocket to peel back.
Soaz trying to get out of a bad situation, but they've all jumped on him. Playful and Trickster, but in comes Yank Ghost. Woolite will secure the kill. Culling is on. Amazing. Gonna get fired down the equalizer. Mythi's health bar is evaporating. His unbreakable will comes in too late. That's a double kill for Woolite, who extends his score. And Rocket might be pinging for Baron.
Another double kill for Woolite there. Good engage on Soaz. They realize that, yes, he might be nimble. Yes, he might be swift, but we can still catch him. Using Nautilus ultimate in order to trail him. Yes, he might hop over the wall, but he will still get knocked up. Yankos connects the Q. Amazing is dead, no smite. Looking at a 9,000 goldie, 8,000 goldie rather here for Rocket against Origin, a team that has had the biggest gold leads in the LCS so far.
Yeah, Rocket playing this out fantastically. Yankos in particular has been setting up these fights. And they're roving together. They're a team with a mission, a team with a purpose, and that purpose is to take down Origin for the first time. Let's see this again. It all started with a catch on Soaz.
Yeah, Soaz gets caught here. Meanwhile, the dragon just spawned on live too, so I wonder which team's gonna pick that up. But look at this. Yes, he hops over the wall, but he's still trailed by Nautilus LD. Yankos goes in, and the fight's over at this point. You know, you lose one of your flank opponents. Amazing. This is why we sometimes don't like the Evelynn, because not a main tank. She has to come in from the side, surprise the enemy, start the fight. As we see in our picture-in-picture, now Rocket picking up their fourth dragon. Just one more. Baron, four dragons, 8,000 gold.
You got map control when you've got the fights won, Krepo. Now, with the Baron buff, with dragon number four, they're looking to start entering the end game here. Nukeduck, Steven, and Woolite are all roving together with Yankos, of course, around the side. Also with Vander. See if Origin can stem the tide. In comes the Culling. Niels doesn't spend it on the wave, however. Aki is down right there. See what Rocket can make of it.
We've seen Rocket play decently well from behind and try and hang on. It's one of the first times we've seen them in the lead. Let's see how well they can close.
Looking to Dredge Line, dodged away by Playful Trickster from Soaz. Inhibitor, however, is not going to be so lucky. Down it goes, 30 minutes on the clock. Rocket have cracked the Origin base. And this is looking to be an upset if it keeps going this way. The fight's on. Equalizer down, but Peke and Mythi zoning Nukeduck about in the back. And in comes Nukeduck, slides and glides. And everyone from Origin is evaporating. There's a double kill to Nukeduck. They paid with Yankos yet again, but they can keep on shoving in the base.
And this Sivir pick is paying dividends. Rocket first picked it, but we've seen these fights. Expect as planned with his Vladimir as we see Nukeduck take down the cow for an extra.
That's
there, but I also just want to point out this Vladimir wants to dive on the AD carry, but spell shield blocks one spell, and then on the hunt makes you even quicker than it goes Vladimir. And Rocket, they're taking this game.
They
second
are.
Win in the LCS.
The
ace comes out.
That is it. 31 minutes in, Rocket become the first team to take down Origin. What a win it was. Smiles on their faces there, and they definitely earned it.
Man, this was a six-man victory for Rocket, in my opinion. Fantastic draft. Played to the execution. Very well punished. What weaknesses Origin had. Played around their own weaknesses slow enough to catch up to the point where they had the group, and I think second dragon, that was a crucial point. We talked about it in the pause. Mythi and Amazing were clearing vision. Not sure if the pause affected them. To the extent where he kind of forgot, you know, where is Rocket, what are they doing, can he catch us? But Niels was clearing bot wave, Soaz was clearing top wave because of the wave control of Rocket, and then yeah, suddenly you're clean wards, enemy shows up, kills you, you're still stuck clearing those waves, dragon goes down, and then the temple for Rocket, not enough pressure, not enough wave clear on Origin side to catch back up.
No, and considering what happened in the beginning of this game, it looked like Origin were just slowly getting little edges, slowly getting little things for them. It just completely turned around. Amazing there on your screen. Well, for whatever reason, whatever happened, Origin have been handed their first loss in a most unexpected manner, and Rocket will be very happy with their performance today.
I mean, I like it for the league. It makes things more exciting. I
yeah.
think this is good for Origin too, because obviously they're playing with a goal. They just want to get better, and it's easy to win. Mm-hmm. It's harder to lose, obviously, but you learn more from losses than you do from victories.
It's very true.
And they have these veteran players that obviously this is not the first time they've lost a game. This is not the first time they've had crushed expectations. Of course they wanted the 6-0, but very interesting to see how they bounce back. Speke still greeting the fans regarding, even though he just lost the game. I like seeing that.